Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to discuss how you can use pointers and structures together in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos on my YouTube channel. Now, I am going to implement a structure declaration first. Then I will be processing that structure with the help of pointer. So first I am including a header file stdio.h, then I am declaring a structure whose name is number. It will be having three members of different data types. So first one is A of integer type, B float type, and character is of C is of character type. So this structure name is number and it is having three members of different data types. Now inside main function, I am going to declare variable n pointer p. So n is a normal variable of structure type and p is a pointer to structure. So p can store address of n, and through p I can access all the values which are stored inside n variable. So first I am assigning values through n. So n dot a equals to 10, n dot b equals to 12.5, and n dot c equals to a. So this way I have initialized all the members of structure through variable n. Now I am assigning address of n into p pointer. So now p is having address of n. So it means I can access all the members which are stored inside n variable through this p pointer. So now you can see I am going to use printf statement which will display values of a, b, c through this p pointer. So here you have to notice that I have used p and then arrow notation. For arrow notation I have used hyphen and greater than sign. So remember that whenever you want to access members of structure through pointer, then you have to use this arrow notation. So now printing value of b, again I have to use this arrow notation, and similarly for printing value of c, p arrow c. So this way I have implemented the code in front of you. Here you can see I have initialized values of structure members through its variable, that is n. And I have printed values of ABC which are members of structure through pointer P. So this way I have accessed the members of structure through pointer. Now I am going to execute this code. You can see the output. A is printing 10, B is printing 12.5, and C is printing 8. And these informations are correct. So I am able to print the information which are stored in N variable and inside ABC members of N variable through pointer p. So this way if you assign address of structure variable into its type, if you assign address of structure variable into structure pointer, then through that pointer we can access all the members of structure. And remember that for structure variable you have to use dot operator, and for pointer you have to use this arrow notation. So this is the difference between structure variable and structure pointer. I hope you have understood the relation between structure and pointer through this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.